Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Microsoft's Java for Beginners series. My name is Brian Benz, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. I'm joined by Kirk Pepperdine today, who's going to talk to us about collections. Kirk, do you want to introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about collections?
Hi, Brian. Thanks for having me here. I'm a principal engineer in the Java engineering group, and we're responsible for building Microsoft's version of OpenJDK. Java libraries have support for different data structures that are built on top of array, which we covered in a previous session. These fall into the categories of collections and maps, and that's what we're going to explore in these two upcoming sessions. In addition to language support for array, Java comes with library support for the interfaces collection and map. The collection interface is further subdivided into a set, a list, and a queue. Here are a number of implementations for set. There's more in the library. You can find references to them in the Java doc. We can see here what we have is link hash set, tree set. The commonality for a set is that an instance of an object can only exist one time in the set. If we try to enter that object more than one time in the set, then that second instance will overwrite the first one. Also, no order is implied in the set. With list, we have a slightly different situation in that we can have multiple copies of the same instance in any of these lists. And also, these lists will keep insertion order. And finally, we have support for a queue, and the queues come in either the traditional view, which is like LIFO or FIFO, but there's also support for DEC, which means that you can add and remove to either end at the same time. Let's take a look at lists. So I'm going to declare a list. I'm going to parameterize it with a string. Say this is a list. Equals new. I'm going to use an array list as my concrete implementation. And as always, we have to import our interface. Let's start by looking at list.add1. And I'm going to add another one. So I'm going to do a list.add1 again. If I print out the length of this, we should see that we should come up with a value of 2. And let's take a look at the contents of list. And the next thing I want to do is look at the contents of the list, but looking at each of the items individually. So we can do that by saying list.forEach. I'll put in a value for here, and here I'm going to sys out the value. Now, the one thing that the collections interface allows us to do is to use the more traditional for loop instead of using this functional interface for each. So I'm going to say for string value, put a single colon there. And I'm just going to put list in here. And now we can just print out each individual value in that list. So that's just going to iterate through the list and allow us to print everything out. So let's see how this all runs. I'm going to see we have 2. I have 1, 1, and 1, 1, 1, 1. So that's all really exciting. Let's add another value here. So I'm going to list.add. In this case, instead of putting it in the next element, I'm going to say, let's put it in slot 4. And I'm going to put in the value of 4 here. And when I run this code, I'm going to get an index out of bounds exception. All right, so the index is 4, but the size is 2. Now, what I can do now is I can say list.add2, and list.add3. When I run this, everything's going to be fine. We're going to get all the expected results. So what was the difference between this run and the previous run? The array list expects these values to be contiguous, so it doesn't want any breaks in the map. What I did was I added to slot 0 and slot 1, then tried to add to slot 4, leaving 2 and 3 empty. So when it tried to add, it expected something in slot 2 and 3. It wasn't there, so it's going to throw an index out of bounds exception. And obviously when I filled in those two slots, that corrected the problem, and that allowed me to add to the next empty slot. Let's try converting this code to a set and see how that works. So I'm just going to say this is a set, a string. Okay. And I'm going to put in here a hash set as a concrete implementation. So let's just change this value to set. So we can say, again, set. We're going to use an add method here all the way along. So set add one, set add one, and set again. Now we'll just see what this actually looks like. So as we do that, we can see that we get a complaint. And the complaint says we can't add to set because it can't be applied to int string. So we need to remove that because there's no ordering in a set. So we can look at the set size. We can print the contents of the set in its entirety. And we can functionally iterate over the set. Or we can literally iterate over the set using this procedural method. Okay, so we don't need these anymore, so we can get rid of them. And run this. And we're gonna see that we can only add the one once, so the second time we add it, it's not going to do anything. It'll effectively replace the old version with the new version. And then we can add 2 and 3, just as we would expect. And then after that, as we iterate through these values and print them, we're going to get the expected output.
Thanks, Kirk. That was great. So that was collections. Also check out Java Maps, where Kirk's going to expand on that a little bit as well. And please check out the rest of the topics in Microsoft's Java for Beginner series.
Thank you, Brian.